Hello, I'm Alex Davies, founder of Wealth Club. Today I'm with Mark Chadwick of Dowgate Wealth to talk about the Dowgate Wealth UK Best Ideas Investment Portfolio. So Mark, for those who aren't familiar, could you give us a bit of background about Dowgate Wealth and you and your team?
Yeah, thanks very much for seeing me today, Alex. I began my career at Hargreaves Hale in 1994, and I suppose my lucky break came in 1997 when I became the assistant to Giles Hargreaves. And later that year, we launched the Marlborough Special Situations Fund. I worked with Giles on subsequent fund launches, and we were also managing bespoke discretionary portfolios. In 2012, we took the decision to split the fund management business and the private client portfolio business, and I became solely in charge of those discretionary portfolios. And I built a really strong team of like-minded investors to manage those portfolios. In 2017, Hargreaves Hale was sold to Canaccord Genuity. And then in 2019, myself and the team had just under 700 million of discretionary assets. I'd actually known the team from Dowgate for about 20 years, and I actually managed money for some of their family. So they approached me and asked if I would start a wealth management division for them. After over 25 years at Hargreaves Hale and Canaccord, I thought maybe it was good timing, and I was quite conscious that Giles was possibly going to be stepping down from his role. So I was joined by 8 former Hargreaves Hale members, and we're a team of 11 at Dowgate Wealth. Ben McEwen was previously at Killick, and I started work with him in 2014, and I've worked with Josh Rossfield since 2003. I think it says a great deal about the team and our performance that in the 9 months that I've been working at Dowgate Wealth, we've accumulated over 400 million of assets in such a short space of time.
And what is the UK Best Investment Ideas Portfolio, and what does it aim to do for investors?
We found that the UK investment industry has become very standardised, and the investment process has become more about a risk avoidance rather than actually generating returns for clients. We found that clients haven't really been able to get access to the individual equities or the really interesting, UK small cap IPOs and placings. So we launched the Best Ideas portfolio to give clients a chance to invest in the really exciting smaller companies to generate good returns. And we see this portfolio as being a small part of a high net worth in individual assets to really generate some strong returns.
And what would you say the outlook is for investing in smaller UK companies?
Yeah, well, that's really interesting, because obviously we've seen upgrades in the growth forecast for the UK, and UK GDP is forecast to be at 7.5% this year, with unemployment around 5.5%. And from a lot of the company management meetings we're having, the feedback has been that companies are trading well, and they're feeling really confident in how their business is going. The UK small caps have been really firm over these last 12 months, and we can see that continuing. There's been a lot of IPOs and placings and a lot of fundraising this year, and there was certainly a lot of pushback from fund managers at the early part of the summer, where everyone just had fatigue and that was enough. But we see that we've seen that picking up again now we're back in September, and we're feeling quite bullish about the trajectory of smaller companies.
And tell me, what sort of opportunities are you looking for?
What are we looking for? We'll pretty much look at anything. We see a lot of companies. I think our record this year, I think we saw 105 companies in March, and we average seeing about 60 companies a month. So that gives us huge knowledge of not just about that the individual companies, but of the overall market of how everyone's seeing the economy. So we've seen things like Phoenix Copper. We invested in that one. It's a copper mine in Idaho at 35p. They're now 62p. We're pretty bullish on that one. And then we invested in Zoo Digital, which does the dubbing and subtitles. Disney's their biggest client. We invested in that. They raised money at £1, and we recently took the profit in that at £1.42. And as I say, we love to meet management, and we invested in a very famous investment called a manager called Vin Marie, and we've made money with her twice already. And she launched a cash shell in March. She raised £100 million, and they're currently £1.15. And you know, we expect her to do a deal by the end of the year.
And are there any types of companies that you avoid?
Yeah, as I say, we'll look at anything, but I think we're very conscious of companies that are struggling with aren't able to pass on their input costs. I think we've got one eye on inflation and companies that are struggling with shipping.
And what do you look for in a management team?
What do we look for in a management team? I think the key thing with smaller companies is we'd love management teams to have a significant stake in their business. I think we love them to have skin in the game because it really focuses their mind, and then also what is their track record? You know, if they've done very well, you know, once or twice before, then you know they've got that secret sauce and they can do that again.
Can you talk to me about some recent investments you've made and why?
Yeah, sure. So we invested in a company called Kistos in May of this year. They raised £52 million at £1.55. They are a oil exploration and producer in the Netherlands. So they raised £52 million in May to buy Tulip oil in Netherlands. They'd recently floated in November of last year at £1. And again, following that management, the manager is Andrew Austin, who was formerly the chairman of Rockrose Energy, which we'd invested in, and investors made several times their money on that one. And then one we bought very recently, probably a couple of months ago, was pretty small, called Bellascura, which has got an oxygen enrichment technology. We invested in those at 45p. And they are now 95p. They had their results last week. Again, great example. As you know, they've only been quoted for 3 months, and that was the fourth time I met the management on Friday. And it's been really interesting to see the confidence of the management throughout that you know. And that's what we really love about investments, is meeting them every 3 to 6 months and really going on that journey with them. And you can see from their body language how confident they are.
So talking about the journey, what about some longer term investments?
Longer term investments. We invested in Fevertree back in 2014. We invested in the IPO, and again we met them twice pre-IPO, and then again on the IPO. So we joined. That was at £1.34. The shares got to £40 at their high. They have come back a little bit, but we'd say we have taken profits for clients, but we do still hold that across most portfolios. We invested in Alpha FX in 2018. They're an FX and financial technology business. They floated at £1.96. They had results last week, and they confirmed a healthy outlook, and they are £23. It's been a really great investment for us. We've been buying for new clients. We're still buying them here because we still think there's a really strong growth trajectory. We invested in S4, which is Martin Sorrell's new vehicle after he'd left WPP. He raised £68 million at £1.10. And again, following that management, he knew exactly where he could make money in the current market. They had an update today from the market. There was upgrades. I think there's been a bit of profit taking, but the shares are £7.70 as we speak. So again, another one that we've been really pleased with. And then final one, which we again still hold across our portfolios, is Watches of Switzerland, another name that people would recognise. It has sell high-end watches, Rolex, etc. They raised money at £2.70 2 years ago, and their shares are now over £10.
And how risky is it, and what do you do to mitigate those risks?
Obviously, we do get investments wrong, and we're very quick to cut our losers. It's something we learned very early from Giles, and we cut our losers very, very quickly. We phase investors' money into the market, which again I think is quite unusual in the investment industry. We invest as and when we get good ideas or an interesting placing or an IPO comes along. And then we're, again, in with, as regards to the individual investment, we'll also phase that in as well. So we probably won't buy a full unit when we find a good idea. We'll buy half a unit, and then if the investment goes well, then increase that unit. And then we're also quite very quick to move to cash. In 2007-08, we cashed up our portfolios quite quickly, and probably were about 50% cash, which really protected our clients on the downside and gave us a lot of firepower to be able to buy. And we did the same last year. We started to sell down our portfolios, obviously, with COVID last year, and we went about 20% cash. The market was going a bit too quick to go any more than that, but that 20% cash certainly helped our performance and then allowed us to have that firepower to be able to buy the bargains that appeared in late March, April.
And finally, Mark, if people are looking to invest in the UK, why should they consider giving you some of their money?
As I've said, I think the Best Ideas portfolio is a great way for a high net worth individual to invest in great growth UK smaller companies, benefiting from a team with over 100 years experience, and meeting management and finding those real those future gems. Having a concentrated portfolio that can really benefit from our picks.
Mark Chadwick of Dowgate, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Alex.